episode family connection school में आता हूँ. Today we'll be doing English grammar topic present perfect tense. Present perfect tense. We did present progressive tense in that we were using ing form in the first form of verb. Here with the helping verb has had, we are going to use the past participle. What is past participle? Past participle means we can call it the third form of the verb also, or actually we call it past participle. The third form of verb is called past participle, and this past participle is used in the perfect tense. Any of the perfect tense, whether it is present, past or future, we have to use the past participle with the helping verb has had. And this is the affirmative sentence. That means it is a positive sentence. Like I have sung. Now see, this form of the verb is the third form of verb or the past participle. And here we have used the helping verb have with the subject. We have sung. You have sung. He, she, Amit has sung. And they have sung. So see how the third person, how they have used has over here with he, she, Amit. If it's a name or if it's he and she, we have to use have. With they, it's a plural, we have to use have. With you, we will be using have as a helping verb. Now the negative sentence. This was a positive sentence. Here negative sentence, this helping verb will be there. After the helping verb, we have to use not. That means the subject will come first, then the helping verb will come. Not will come and then the past participle, right? I, the subject, then the helping verb, then we will use not, and then the past participle, that is some. In the interrogative sentence, as I had told you in the progressive tense also, that helping verb, the sentence starts with the helping verb. Here the sentence starts with the helping verb, has, have. After has, have, the subject will come, and then will come the past participle, like have I sung, and question mark is there only in interrogative sentence. So have, here we have used the helping verb first, then we have used the subject, and then we are writing the past participle, that is sung. Have you sung? Has he, she, Amit sung? Have they sung? So see, I told you the past participle will come, and then over here helping verb will come first, and maybe the subject will come in the interrogative sentence. And never forget to put the question mark. Now this is negative interrogative. Negative interrogative, again we have to use have at first, then the subject. After the subject we will use not, because it's a negative sentence, and then the past participle. Have I not sung? Haven't I sung? Have we not sung? See, the past, the first is coming the helping verb, then it is coming the subject, then we are using not, and then we are using the past participle. This is the way you use in the negative interrogative sentence. Now the uses of present perfect tense. When we are using the present perfect tense, to show activities completed in the immediate past. Immediate past, when we complete the activity, we are using the perfect tense. How? He has finished his work. Now this work has been finished just a few minutes back. So we are writing it. He has finished his work. He has just struck 9. It has just struck 9 means what? Means just now. Like after the 5 minutes, you are just saying that it has just struck 9. So this is the present perfect tense when we use. To express past action whose time is not given. Now the time which is not given, and we express in the past. That means she has been to Rajasthan. See here what they have used. To express past action means she had gone. She has been. Has been we are using, not had. Past tense is not there, because she has just now, like she has gone and she has come back. So we write this way. I have never known him to be angry. To describe an action that began in the past and is still continuing. When we are describing an action that is that began in the past and it is continuing till now. That means he has known her for a long time. We haven't seen Seema for several years. Now, with adverb phrases like already, today, never, ever, this week, etc. Also, we use the